Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to First Presbyterian Church. And First Fridays, we're going to go ahead and get started as people are making their way over from lunch. We're very excited to have lunch return today and glad that so many of you all were able to enjoy that. So we have one more program for the season next month on June 4th. It'll be our very own Dr. William Bates playing us a program, and it'll be preceded by lunch as well. So I hope you can come back and join us for that next month. But today we have the organ scholars, our three organ scholars. And I wonder, I'm sure a lot of you had the opportunity to study an instrument when you were growing up, and maybe you had lessons, but I wonder how many had the opportunity to study the organ. And it is a somewhat unique opportunity that it's a privilege to be able to offer here. And, you know, we believe that the organ is important to our worship, and we need organists to play the organ to make that music. So we're glad to be able to offer lessons and to be able to bring up the next generation of organists. And we're excited to hear them today and what they've been working on all year. So before we get started, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we do give you the thanks and praise for this day, for the music that we'll hear today, your creation. We thank you for Simmons and Latimer and Ezra and the way that you've blessed them this year and their studies, the talents that you've given them, and their desire to use those for you. So we ask that you would be with them as they play, and that you would be with each of us as we hear and participate in this music, that all would be done to your glory. We pray this in your name. Amen. Well, we'll start with Simmons. Simmons Easterling has been playing the organ for a few months. Each of the scholars had piano lessons. They come with piano proficiency. And Simmons has been in our children's and youth choir program her entire life, from K-4, from the very beginning. And she has other varied interests, soccer and jujitsu. So we're excited for her first performance today.
Thank you.
as Latimer comes up, we'll embarrass him a little bit. When I first came here 5.5 years ago, Dr. Bates sent me a video of a very young Latimer playing the organ. And so not long after that, the Organ Scholars Program was formed, and he started taking lessons. So he's been playing the organ for quite some time, and he's also been in our Children's and Youth Chorus Program for many, many years, and he plays weekly at Sherwood Forest ARP. And finally, Ezra Blackwell. Ezra is graduating, and he's off to Hillsdale College, where he will continue his organ studies. Ezra has also been in our children's choir program from the very beginning.
First grade.
Pretty much, yeah. So all of our scholars are members of the youth chorus, and they're active in the music ministry. And then some have even gone on to play elsewhere throughout town, or Newberry in Ezra's case. He plays at Newberry ARP each week, has been doing that this year.
Thank you.
So it's the end of the school year, the end of our season, so we do have a little ceremony. And if I could ask Roseanne to come up and join me. Several months ago, Roseanne McDowell came to me and said she had a desire to start a scholarship for the Oregon Scholars. And so we have established that, and you know, her desire was to make an investment in these young people's lives, as particularly those who go off to college to continue studying Oregon, that they may continue to use their gifts in the ministry of the church. So we're very pleased to have the inaugural awarding of the scholarship today. And let me read the inscription on the certificate. So the McDowell Scholarship is awarded annually to a First Presbyterian Church organ scholar studying organ at the undergraduate level and using his or her musical gifts in church ministry. It is given by Roseanne McDowell to the glory of God and in memory of Broadus and Moselle McDowell of Columbia and their daughter Melinda McDowell. Broadus, a deacon, and Moselle, both of whom loved the Lord and the hymns of the church, for decades supplied piano and voice lessons to their children, Jack, Melinda, Judy, Roseanne, and Jim. The Lord's people gained 3 choir members from these 5 children. So I'm going to hand this to you. And then it is our pleasure to award this first scholarship to Ezra Blackwell. Come on. Roseanne, these are for you. It's a token of our appreciation for your heart for the Lord and your thought to do this for the Oregon Scholars. So thank you. And I'd also like to thank Dr. Cole for his leadership in the music ministry, and to Gloria Barrett for all of her organizational skills that keep us running on the right track and really make all of these things happen. And if I could ask all 3 of you to come back up here. Just have another little thing, kind of a funny thing here. You can stand over there, that'd be good. End of the year gift for you all, no hiding behind the pulpit. Well, let me go ahead and pass them out so you can show them off. The different heights don't mean anything, you know, they're just organ pipes, so they have different pitches, different heights. So these are old organ pipes. And just as a little remembrance of this year, this season, and these came originally from Doug Crocht. We were making a video about the organ for the first time there was going to be a 225 celebration, and Doug had brought me these organ pipes, and they've been in my office for a while, and when I had the thought to use them, I asked Doug just to make sure he would be okay with me sending these off into the wide world with the Oregon Scholars, and I wanted to read you his reply to that. He said, "The kingdom of God is any situation where Jesus is recognized as king. His will is obeyed, and the fruit of obedience is enjoyed. Old wooden organ pipes are good fruit of obedience and must be shared with the wide world. Who best but an organ scholar that will be encouraged to follow the sound by receiving such a symbol of their voice to the world?" So I would add to that just as each pipe has a voice that is part of the whole organ, so you have an individual voice that is part of God's created beauty made manifest as you play the organ. So as you keep these pipes and when you see them, let it be a reminder to use your voice and your life and your organ playing for your creator and redeemer as a testimony to who he is and all for his glory. Thank you guys. And if you indulge me for one more moment, it's Simmons' birthday today.